I feel I've done a pretty good job of being like PG-13 on my channel, but it's about to change just a little bit because I'm a big boy and I trust that you are a big man or big woman and you can handle this, because in this video, we're gonna talk about why you are fucked. So stay tuned. What's up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And yeah, the only reason I'm being a little bit vulgar in this video, and you know, the F word's not that vulgar, you know, I could say much worse. Anyways, is because we're gonna be talking about Russell Brand, his book Recovery that I've talked about before, but we are going to focus on the aspects of relationships today. I know that many people out there who are watching this have toxic relationships over and over and over again, and they can't understand why. What's interesting about Russell Brand is that he has created a book that can help anybody who feels stuck, okay? And I'm about to explain why. And it all starts by understanding Russell Brand's philosophy of why people are in so much pain. Now, I'm about to show you a clip from Russell Brand, but I just want to throw this out there to you. It is 2017. Studies show that more people are anxious, depressed, struggle with other forms of mental illness than ever before. We have mass shootings every 5 seconds, it seems like. We just had an attack in New York. Just people are in pain and it's not being addressed. And one of the reasons it's not being addressed is because people are so unconscious of this pain and what they are doing, and then they eventually get to a breaking point. So hopefully this video will help anybody out there who is experiencing pain because of relationships. So check out this clip.
Who's not in pain in this crazy world? Pain is everywhere, it's everywhere, and it won't ever end until we address our inner constellation, our inner coordinates, how we feel within will change us and will change the outer world.
All right, that clip came from a video that I will link in the description along with Russell Brand's book, and the video was called Unfuck Yourself from the Modern World. Now, what this video entails, and you can go check it out, but I'm gonna break it down for you. Russell Brand does a very simple cycle of how this pain happens and then reoccurs over and over, and we get stuck in this cycle and never get out of it. So for this video, I will be focusing on the topic of relationships. I hope to do more on different specific subjects, but I just want to let you know, like, ask yourself, can you relate to what I'm about to share? Because if you can, the good news is there is a solution. So let's jump right into it. The first part of this cycle is pain, some kind of pain. A feeling that we have inside, typically based on ideas of what we think we need to be okay. Talking about relationships and unhealthy relationships, whether it's dating or whether it's sleeping with random people, whatever it is, typically that pain when it comes to relationships is loneliness. We feel lonely. We need to do something about that loneliness. We do not know how to sit with that loneliness, so therefore we have to take action to combat that loneliness. Part two of this cycle is using an addictive agent to soothe and distract. So when you're feeling lonely, what do to combat that loneliness? Do you go and find a random stranger to hook up with at a bar? Do you go on Tinder? Do you go on OkCupid? Do you go on Facebook? What are you doing to distract and soothe yourself from that original pain of loneliness? Part three is a very important one in this cycle, which is a temporary anesthesia. So anesthesia, that is something to numb, okay? That is something to get rid of that pain, but the key word here being temporary. So you're feeling lonely. In order to get rid of that loneliness, you go and find a hookup, or you find somebody that probably doesn't meet the standards that you deserve. And what that does is temporarily, it numbs that pain. Next, you experience consequences. If you are somebody who gets into toxic relationships over and over, these consequences are very obvious. You start fighting a lot. You start feeling terrible. You start feeling depressed. Now, in my experience, People who turn to sex or relationships as a way to numb this pain are typically like a cup with a hole in it. They will never be full. So in turning to a relationship to subside that pain, they soon find out that their glass isn't getting full. This person that they have brought into their life is not doing what they wanted them to do. Maybe it lasted for a little bit. Maybe it lasted during that honeymoon phase, but because they constantly have these feelings of loneliness or they need attention, that's when the relationships really get bad, because you want more, they can't give more. And what you're really chasing is a feeling that you're never fully going to get. So the consequences involve fighting, bad relationships, which lead to bad breakups. Or if you're somebody who just goes out there and just, you know, likes to sleep around, there are typically consequences. These consequences can be sexually transmitted diseases. These consequences can be developing bad relationships with your friends, with your family members. People in your life are saying like, hey, you are hooking up with new people all the time and you're still sad and depressed. Like, people pointing out these things to you. Maybe you're bringing around terrible men or terrible women around your family and your friends. These are the consequences that we're talking about. So after these consequences is the fifth part of this cycle, which is shame, guilt, that leads to more pain or low self-esteem. So let's go back through this cycle real quick. You were lonely. You found somebody to get rid of that loneliness. It was only a temporary fix. Now you're starting to have consequences, right? You're starting to get into fights. You're starting to realize this person is terrible for you. I know a bunch of women who get into relationships with men who are verbally or even physically abusive. These consequences. Now, because of that decision you made, you experience shame or guilt, which leads to more pain or self-esteem, thus restarting the whole cycle of pain again. So what happens? Eventually you break away from that relationship, that bad relationship. You finally broke away, but how long does it take for that pain to return and you jump right back into that cycle? Everybody does this in some way, shape, or form. It's just, are you going to be conscious about it or are you going to be unconscious about it? Are you going to bring awareness into what you're doing? And if so, you're learning that no matter how many times you repeat this cycle, you are still ending up back at point one where you have pain. And that is no way to live. And like I said at the beginning of this video, more and more people are struggling with pain and they're reaching these breaking points. But like I said, there is a solution. I'm gonna do another video on this about how the best thing that I ever did in my life was staying single and staying celibate for a year and a half. Best thing I ever did in my life, because it taught me to get comfortable with the loneliness. And once you can get comfortable with that, the world is your oyster. I encourage you that if you can relate to this pain when it comes to relationships, you go and check out Russell Brand's book, Recovery. It is not just for recovering drug addicts and alcoholics. It's a misconception. Russell Brand made this book for anybody out there who is stuck in a cycle of pain. So if you check in the link in the description below, it is an Amazon affiliate link. So you get the book at no extra cost. That book then provides more support for this channel so I can keep making videos to help you with your mental health, your mental illness, and all that kind of stuff. So please check out this book, click the link below. But there are solutions. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, because that helps me know if there's more topics you want me to do on this. I can literally take this same cycle and use it for a million other things, and I'm going to, but I would like to know which ones you want me to cover about these cycles that you're starting to notice that you're stuck in that are not bringing you the relief that you thought they were. See, if you check out my other video that I'll link up in the info card, where Russell Brand said, us addicts are the lucky ones. See, our pain manifests into a cycle which leads to drugs and alcohol, where it's bright as day that we're suffering. For other people, it's a lot harder to kind of acknowledge and accept. So If you have some kind of struggle and you want me to do a video on that particular topic, please let me know in the comments below. But aside from that, here is the question of the day. What is your experience with toxic relationships? Did you break free of them? Are you now in healthier relationships? Or do you find yourself being in that same pattern of starting with pain and ending in pain and recycling that pattern all over again? Leave them in the comments below. What's your experience with this cycle of pain when it comes to relationships? But thanks for watching. If you are new here, please click the little round subscribe button right below. I'm always doing videos about mental health, mental illness, addiction, and all that stuff. To the left of me, click or tap on one of those thumbnails because there's a ton of other content on this channel where I talk about things that can help you out up here. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.